In this video, I will show you some of my favorite utility scripts in Reaper, including script 1 allows you to update Reaper quick and easy. Script 2 displays your current grid size and offers an amazing adaptive grid. Script 3 displays what chord you have in your MIDI editor and keyboard. Script 4 is an add-on to the MIDI Explorer that allows you to tune your samples in different notes. And lastly, script 5 is a mind-blowing sampler that is always going to be recording what you're hearing, then you can make a selection and drag this back into the project as many times as you want. For installation instructions, check the description. I have an article in there with all of the steps, and also feel free to grab the Reaper theme I'm using. It's also there in the description. Let's go! This script makes the process of updating Reaper so much easier and faster. Usually for every update you get a little window that looks like this. You have to click proceed to download page. It takes you to the Reaper page, you have to select your system, download it, install it, and all of that. And the whole process takes about 3-4 minutes. But with this thing, it only takes under a minute and it's just so much nicer. It's seamless. You just have to press here and it's gonna download it, install it, and restart Reaper for you. The whole process is automatic, you don't have to do anything. For example, I'm in 7.10 and I need to update to 7.11 and it's just so easy. I'm just gonna click there, it's gonna start downloading, then it tells me that I need to close Reaper, I just click yes, then Reaper's gonna restart, and just like that I updated to 7.11 and the whole process took less than 30 seconds to be honest. Now, not only you can update, you can also click here to see all of the old versions. Maybe you want to go back into any of the older versions for troubleshooting, you can just simply select which version you want, it's gonna start downloading and installing that for you. You can also press this information icon and it's gonna show you the change log of the current update that you have. So you can see whatever is new here. Now, here on this side, you see the pre-release version and I don't recommend getting this because it's usually unstable. But if you wanna test the new upcoming features, you can press the information icon to see what's coming and see if you wanna try any of the new features before it's released and help troubleshoot things in there. You also got this top left menu where you can enable run script on startup. That means that it's just gonna notify you when there's a new version. This window is gonna appear and all you need to do is just click to install and that's it. But yeah, super convenient. And this script was done by FTC and I highly encourage you to donate to this amazing person. And most of the scripts I'm gonna talk about in this video are from FTC. So yes, he's put a lot of work into making Reaper much better. The next script makes me so excited, seriously. So in Reaper, there's actually no way to see your current grid size. And this is annoying because the only way to do it is by right clicking the grid icon in here and you can see what grid size you're at. The other way is my way where I have a bunch of toolbar icons for the grid size. So whenever I'm adjusting the grid size, I'm able to see which size I'm in right now. And this works fine, I like it. But the only thing is that it takes up quite a bit of toolbar space because it's all these icons in here. And now I present you Gridbox by FTC. And it's this little thing right here. And it's so awesome! You can display what current grid size you have and you can use your mouse wheel in here to change the grid size. I'm using my mouse wheel as I move this. So I no longer have the need to have all of these toolbar icons. In fact, I'm gonna delete them now. Bye, 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 bye. And there you go. Now I have so much space in my toolbar. That's so nice. Now, let me show you why this thing is the best. So first, you can actually click and drag this into whatever position you want it on your transport bar, which makes it so nice because it's so seamless. It looks like part of the theme. And once you find a good position, you can lock the position. Not only that, but you can also customize the size, the font, the corners, the colors, and all of these to make it really seem part of your theme. This is how it looks by default, and it looks so well with the Reapertips theme. And if you find yourself that you really like this, you can right click on it, run script on startup, and that's gonna make sure that it's always gonna be there for you. Now, not only you can adjust the grid size by scrolling with your mouse wheel on top of this, you can left click on it and have all of these options. So you can set your grid type to triplets, you can set it to dotted, and you can set it to swing. And one quick way to set it to swing is by holding option or alt and clicking on it, and that's gonna activate the swing. And then you will see as I zoom in, if I hold alt and my mouse wheel, it's gonna adjust the swing strength as I move my mouse wheel in here, which is so awesome. You can visually see where the swing is at right here while you move your mouse wheel. But then the best part of all is this adaptive grip, and it's just magic. Honestly, I've been using this and I haven't had the need to change my grip size ever because this is just so smart. So let's say that I choose medium adaptive grip, and as I zoom in, it's just gonna set the grid size smaller and smaller. And the size that I pick in here is basically the minimum spacing in between grid lines. For example, if I choose narrowest, I'm gonna see more grid lines. And if I choose widest, I'm not gonna see as many. I will have to zoom in a lot to get to this grid size. So I actually prefer narrowest. I find that it always works the way I want it. But yeah, this thing is amazing. Notice how as I zoom out, it's just gonna increase the grid size. And as I zoom in, it's gonna reveal more and more lines. So just works so well and seamless. Shout out once again to FTC. The next script is very similar, but this time with chords in your MIDI editor. When I run this, you will notice this little box right here at the top left corner. And this box is gonna tell me whatever chord is under my mouse cursor. So if I place my mouse over here, I get an A major, this is C major, F major, and G major. It also works with the notes that you have selected. So if you have something selected, it's just gonna show you this little indication that it's the selected notes, and it's a G major third. And if I select this three, that's a G major. And this thing, once again, is so seamlessly integrated. It's over here, you don't even notice it. You can right click on it and choose Run Script on Startup, so it always shows up. You can also customize the look. There's some options of how it's gonna display the chords. And also you have all of these options to export your current chords. This is super, super cool because you can do project regions, and it's gonna basically make regions with the name of the chords that you currently have. Or you can do project markers, in the case that's useful for your arrangement. You can also do take markers, which is gonna place it right at the take. And also there's test events, which is these at the bottom, which are CC message. And there's also notation events, in the case you do notation. And lastly, there's this chord track, but don't get too excited. This is not like the Cubase chord track. This is just a track with a bunch of empty items with the chord name, which is useful for the project in the case you're doing your arrangement this way. I really like that I'm able to see what chord I'm doing as I keep adding more notes, and it's just always gonna tell me what's under my mouse cursor. Oh, and of course it works with your MIDI keyboard. All you need to do is just go to options and analyze incoming MIDI. So I see what chord I'm doing as I'm playing my MIDI keyboard. Pretty awesome. The next script is called MX Tuner, and it looks like this. It's a little add-on for the MIDI Explorer that allows you to tune any of the samples that you hear in here to any of these notes. A really good way to use this is by docking the MIDI Explorer. You can right-click and dock MIDI Explorer in Docker. So in here, I'm gonna move this over here, and I'm gonna place my MIDI Explorer in here, which is really, really comfortable to use. And then this one right here, I'm gonna right-click again, Window, Dock Window. And now I'm gonna move this little tab over here, and I'm gonna adjust this like this, and that way I have the MIDI Explorer in here and the tuner right below it, and it just looks and works so nice this way. So now I'm gonna go through some of these tonal samples, and you're gonna notice that it's always gonna tell me what note it is, and it's pretty instant. So for example, this one is G sharp, this one is D, this one is G, and like this. It's pretty fast. And the awesome thing about this is that you can play the sample and say, how does that sound in E? You can just select that F, G. But not only that, when you click on a note and this little lock shows up, that means that all of the future samples that you hear are all gonna be tuned to this note. So everything is a G now. And so fast. It does it so fast. You see this pitch changing? That's the thing, tuning the sample like really fast. Now, an interesting thing that you can do with this is that you can either tune it by pitch or by rate, and this will give you different results for different purposes. For example, let's say that we want this sample to be G, and we can just click and drag into the project, and it's gonna be a G. You will see that it pretty much raised the pitch by 5, and that's how it got the G. Now, in this other way, we can do it by rate instead of pitch. And to do so, we right-click the keyboard and select pitch snap and tune with rate. And now you will notice that when I select the sample, it's gonna actually adjust the rate and leave the pitch alone. And you will see the difference between this tune here. Tuning the sample using rate sounds like this. And tuning the sample using pitch sounds like this. Notice how this one doesn't sound as natural as this one. It just sounds like this little artifacts in between. And that's just the pitch algorithm which is working there. And with this one, just a way more natural sound. And it's because this is just being stretched. We're basically playing like if it was a tape machine and just making the sound faster or slower. It's gonna increase or decrease the pitch. So basically this sample was like this and it was a stretch until it sounded 5 semitones up. So yeah, for most situations I would use rate, but sometimes you need the sample to stay in the same length, so I would use pitch in that case. So both ways are awesome. This script is awesome and it makes the process way, way simpler. Lastly, we got what I think is one of the most mind-blowing scripts, and it's called Global Sampler, and it's this thing right here. And it's basically always recording. You will notice that if I load a synthesizer and I start playing with the synthesizer like this, you see, it's recording, and I can click and drag this into the project like this, and that's just so awesome because yeah, you can play around with your synthesizer and maybe you got a really cool sound and like, well, I want that, to just select that and drag it into the project. And now that you have the sample in here, you can further tweak this. Let's say we want to add more stuff to it. Let's play around with Saturn and let's do some alright, that was cool. Let's bring this back into the project and let's put some more plugins into it. Like, we're just literally playing with the sampler and mangling it infinitely and keep bringing it back and just getting a completely new sound every time. So one really fun thing to do is just bringing up the master track and then setting up the play rate in here and then doing some crazy stuff with the LFO. This is like this, a little tilt from here. Alright, I like that. Let's keep this like over here and maybe I really like this jump right there. So let's do that. Pretty cool. So we can select that, bring that back. And now, this is our new sound. So awesome! Like, you can keep going with this and just get new sounds every time. Now we can play with some reverb. I like to play around with this. That was cool. I like that. I like that tail. Awesome, so we literally went from this to this in just a couple of minutes. Very awesome script, and you can also customize the look. There's also this other one called Rainbow, which is nice. There's also this other one called Violet. And you can actually further customize this by using the Global Sampler Theme Editor. And in here, there's also all these options for customization, which is so nice, and you can make it look part of your theme. And that's it. I hope that was useful. And here's another video in case you want to watch more cool things that Reaper can do. Check this out, and I hope to see you next time. Bye bye.